politician whom it deserves.
Thank you. Dear members of our club, dear guests, firstly, I want to make a little introduction that my speech is not according to some project, so don't try to understand according which manual it is made. But today we have such possibilities, the floor is opened. I decided that I have opportunity to present and to share some opinions with you, and maybe some of you decided during the table topic session, using, you know, that for using any question you can give answer what you want. So maybe I push and initiate some of you that you give your feedbacks to my speech during the table topic session. So now to back to our speech. You know, the last week and I think 2 weeks were very energetic in politic means. I don't know, maybe we are in one steps for some. I believe that we are from such evolutional stage, because each society and each country we are moving in such sinusoidal, yeah? So if we have after Orange Revolution some improvement in our democratic values, and our country was on the track of democratic development, so we, now we have such a sharp decrease, and I am sure that the same as spring comes this year. It was late, it was in April, but spring comes. So I'm sure that this administration, I don't think government, because I cannot say government is about these people, this temporary administration will be kicked out in some moment and will go out from our country. But the question is, when we discuss and debate and at work with my friends, you know, some part of people says, come on, Vasil, calm down, nothing won't change. The nation has such politicians whom it deserves. So look, how many people are drunk, how many people are not working in an efficient way, and they don't want to put garbage to the, some box. So what I'm talking about, some democratic values, some high standards, because if they don't want to clean the apartment and they won't, they don't want to change anything with their personal life, what we can say about the country? Another group of people says, you know, changes will come, but this administration is too strong. We cannot change it in democratic way. Maybe will come some another strong leader, some new Washington, and will build our happy Ukraine for us. Maybe it would be a good example, but we are not living in the country Oz, and nobody will come on such a balloon and don't change our society. And the third part of people says, yes, we should do something. Do something, and very often we can see that this, I feel as myself that very often I feel like I need to do something, but I don't want what I should do, and what I should do, and very often this willing to do something, it feels in some inefficient actions or actions that are maybe a little bit marginal, or at least these actions cannot change a society. So for first group of people who say that this administration is too strong, I say, look at snow. Remember Soviet Union, remember Nazi Germany, all the administrations were strong, and they are in the past. So the same will be with this other administration. For the second group of people who say that we cannot change nothing, I think that in each nation, the group of people who influence on society, who are such dynamo machine as in airspace, who push Gagarin to the space, it's such dynamo machine, it's maybe 5-7% of society, not more. And what can do this 5-7%? We cannot influence on this administration, but we can influence on opposition. Because I don't mean directly Chernyakov, Klitschko, Yatsenyuk or some other, but opposition as general. Today's opposition will be a power tomorrow or after tomorrow. The same as tomorrow or after tomorrow government will go to opposition. Today's administration, they don't need our thoughts, and in fact we cannot change it. But we can influence and try to push opposition, and we have no perfect opposition leader. But I think we should build very strong non-government society organizations, and this organization should have strong impact on the opposition leaders, opposition MPs. When opposition MPs will understand that they are depends not on money, not on the wallet of the people who give some grants and finance this program, when they will understand that their program depends on the usual people, they should go from flat to flat, from apartment to apartment, go from heart to heart of people and try to understand and answer to the demands of the need of these people, of our people. So I think that we should work and try to change, build a real strong non-government movement and try to make opposition as we want to see it. Not that opposition maybe that we have now, but we can try to push and form to change our opposition. And in this way we can push some changes in society and maybe in different ways, but this administration will go out and then we will have real set country, set government, set we can say that really it is government that represents us, represents our nations, and in this transmission mechanism change opposition, and opposition will be become tomorrow's government is the correct way how to change our country in a more efficient way. And I think that really that it's true that government, that each nation has a government who it deserves. But we are not blame for this administration because we are bad or not clever enough. Our problem, I mean, our society, that we are not active enough. We don't try to go heart by heart. We don't try to speak about this problem with our colleagues, with our friends. And such activities, it doesn't mean that you should go each day to some demonstration. You should not each day make some, I don't know, strike on your work. But you can make some, I think it's even much more hard to work from year to make such initiative, for example, as Democratic Alliance, or for example, as Initiative Drishi, or some another. We have a lot of examples of such non-government initiatives, and in such way to change our country. And I am sure that if all of you spend this evening time here, not in bar, not in some pub, you are active, and with the help of such people of you, we can really change our society. Thank you.